everyone, and welcome back to Arcade Saturdays. Every Saturday we find some old classic arcade games. We play them, we relive some nostalgia, we have some fun, we tell some tales, we do all that good stuff. This week, we are playing an absolute classic, Daytona USA. There's the logo. Holy smokes, just in the nick of time. But of course, this is Daytona USA, this is from Sega. Most of the times you ever saw these, they were two racing cabinets side by side, and you actually got to race against another person. Sometimes, if you were lucky, you had four, which I've done that one before, too. That one was pretty cool. I've heard that you can actually find them where they have, like, all the field. You know, every single one of them is its own car, but I've never seen that. That must be something interesting to see. That really must be something cool. But we always saw the ones that only had the two. There was a mall that we used to go to all the time, had one of these. And man, was this a dollar-eating machine. Yes, this bad boy cost one whole dollar to play. You got your money's worth. I mean, it was definitely a great game, but holy shit, we put a lot of money into this thing. But let's jump into it. Shit, why not? Let's do it. This is on the PS3. Where did I get this? This is on the PlayStation Store. I don't really have a box that's Daytona USA or anything. This was just something right towards the end of the PlayStation 3's life. They made a whole bunch of arcade games for whatever reason, and this one popped up, and I said, man, I gotta have that. You know, it's Daytona USA. This is one of my favorite games. So, let's just go with the arcade. There is a multiplayer, which I think you can go online, yeah. I don't really know the options or anything. I haven't checked any of that stuff out. I have played this before. Normal. We're just going to keep everything on normal. Mirror mode. No, we need to turn it off, because we just want to run the straight tracks. Okay. Of course, we always did beginner because, hey, man, you know, that's the most like NASCAR actually is. The other ones, these are like road courses. Oh, shit, and I got advanced. Son of a bitch. And we never played the manual. Well, maybe we did. I don't really remember too much. But, I'm stuck with this one. I don't even know if I can do this or not. Oh, my God, look at this. But of course, this is classic Daytona USA. This is a lot cleaner than, you know, the old game. This is definitely pulled up into high res. It even looks cleaner, too. It feels a lot cleaner, too. Feels cleaner. You hear me? It feels nice only because I know I've said it before that anything that you play with the joystick... is a lot better than... Oh, God. It is a lot better than actually playing it with the wheel. But I used to love the cabinets for these. They used to be very realistic. The one thing I definitely remember more than anything else was they had the speakers. Oh, my God. They had the speakers in the cabinet that were right behind your ear. So by the time you got out of that cabinet, you were deaf. I mean, just stone cold deaf. We had the one, it's like I said, we had the one that had the two-player cabinet. Did we have the one that had the four-player cabinet? That is one that I would have to ask a couple of my buddies about, because I don't remember if it was four-player or two-player. I do remember us playing four-player one time. So we at least did it once, where we had all four of the guys sitting down playing one of these damn things. I remember orchestrating that because we could never, whenever we always went out of town, because, you know, we lived in, you know, bum fuck Florida, where, you know, there was nothing in town. You had to go out of town to be able to get to anything cool. So we would load up in a car. We'd take a day, you know, Saturday, sometimes into Sunday, much to the chagrin of our parents. We would make a day of it where we would go out, you know, we'd hit the mall, and we'd hit that arcade, and we'd burn all of the money that we had left, And we'd play video games. You know, that's what we do. Or we'd walk around and, you know, we'd look at all the stuff that we couldn't afford because we threw all the money away in video games. But we could never get everybody to go out at once. There were six or seven of us, you know. And at any one time, you could get maybe three guys to go, if you're lucky. It was mostly just two of us. You know, you could never really get the other guys to go. But there was one time I remember where we had at least four people, if not five. I know the right towards the end of the school year, my senior year, we were able to get the whole gang to go out to West Palm Beach. Oh my Jesus Christ. We don't really go out to West Palm Beach very much. We always went the other way to Fort Myers. It was a much easier town to navigate around in. But we actually got everybody together to go out there, and we all went bowling. I know. Crazy shit. Oh, did I make... Oh, God. And I'm going to lose this because for some reason I just cannot make turns to save my life. God. I'm cutting. Oh, damn it. Hey, I got 12th, man. That's got to be better than I've ever done at this. Game over. Game over. That song, man. Once you've heard it enough, it haunts your ass. Technically, we just burned all four quarters playing. That's so sad. That's really so sad. I just thought about that. The amount of times you can use rewind. Oh, they added a whole bunch of stuff in for this version of the game. Again, stuff that I have never even remotely touched. A whole bunch of extra things. If you guys have a PS3 and you want to go check it out, definitely check it out. I think this is also on the PlayStation Now, which I have heard has become like the deal of the century at this point. Even if you don't have a PlayStation, apparently you can play them on Sony TVs, and you can now play them on like tablets and PCs. It's crazy. It's crazy stuff. But yeah, no, because this game used to cost a dollar, that was my whole dollar. So we're going to do it again. We're gonna play the track we know, though, because we, like I said, we always used to play the beginner track because we couldn't stand the other ones, man. It was especially with the wheel, because it was so realistic that you had to crank that wheel as hard as possible to get it to turn, and we could never get it to turn at all. We were horrible. In the arcades, we were horrible at this game. But it was one of the few first games where you could race your friends, you know, where you had two cars side by side where you could actually race your friends. And, So it was, you know, it was worth it. It was one of those, you finally got to be truly competitive. And I know back in the 90s they had these traveling IndyCar video games where I think they were set up with like five or six. They might even be set up with 10. I don't know, but they had these like traveling IndyCar video games where they would go to like different events and things like that. It used to cost like $5 to play it, you know. Nowadays they have the, you know, you'll see like 20 Mech Warrior friggin' things that are like $30 to play. If anyone's ever seen those. But back then, you know, your options were extremely limited, and, you know, they didn't look pretty, but you were racing with real people, so, you know, it was actually a thing. But this was one of the first games where, you know, you were actually sitting beside your buddy, and you could actually play, and it was moderately cheap. You know, $1 wasn't so bad. Oh, shit. That was crazy. I never really understood. Every time I come around the Sonic Mountain thing there, I don't know what it's called. I'm sure it's called Sonic Mountain. But every time you come around Sonic Mountain, there's that billboard with the guy with the eyes. I don't know what that is. But in high resolution, it looks like Ralph Fiennes from Strange Days. Am I wrong? I mean, seriously. Oh, God. Come on. There we go. I'm just saying. That's what it looks like. It's nuts. I'm not doing bad here at all. This is, oh God, the whole field just came up on me. again, the I was much worse in the arcades. And I could never take a turn either. That was like the worst turn in the world. But in the arcades, we were bad. We could never make it all the way to the end, you know, because it said it's got 8 laps, and I think the best position I could ever get in the arcade was maybe 15th, maybe 20th. I don't know. We had fun. We just kept running just to see how far we could get, because we knew that we were up against clock. Is there no damage in this? Did I turn the damage off? Because it, you know, in the Arcadia, you had that weird, every time you hit something, you know, your car would deform and it'd be all weird. Did I hit the goal? I placed 14th. That song. Oh, I get to put my name in. Awesome. Awesome. Very awesome. Wonder where my, wonder if there's another name, because I have played this. What? Oh, you're not going to show the names? Oh, that's some bullshit. The amount of times you can use rewind has increased. I still haven't played that. But what time is it? What is the time that we got going on here? We can do one more. We can do one more. Difficulty. Arcade. Oh, there is a different difficulty. Oh, my God. Time limit arcade. It was not mirrored. We never had it mirrored. Laps endurance. Oh, Jesus. I think I ran one of those endurance. That was probably one of the few times that I was actually able to make it all the way through to the first place. And I think I lost anyways because I wound up wrecking or something. But I have done that. But this is the actual arcade settings. Arcade, time limit. Dude, let's do this. Yes, let's do it the way I'm supposed to. Let's see just how bad it really truly is. I am not going manual. I always went automatic. We used to think it was funny. Even though we were on automatic, we used to think that the position that you put the gear shift in used to help. Like, we thought, I don't know why we would think that, but we used to, oh shit, we used to think that if you put it in fourth place that you used to go faster. I don't know why that was. I really don't. Apparently there was something in our brains that made us think, God, what, this is fast as hell. This is definitely a lot faster than it used to be. And the car is vibrating. How do I change the... Okay, that's not it. No. There it is. Oh, yeah, look. Car's deforming. That's what it is. It's the arcade. How do I... Okay. Oh, wow. Yeah, look at the car. I know if you beat it up enough, I always like this view. This is... This actually, when I grew up and started playing games like on the PlayStation and everything else, I always wound up coming back to the hood view like this. It just, you know, I grew up playing Daytona like this, so yeah, I might as well keep it up. But, what was I saying? I don't even remember what I was saying anymore. Okay, I remember now. When you beat the car up enough, you can see it too in the wheels. When you beat the car up enough, the wheels will start shaking. The whole thing will start just shaking like crazy. One of the few games where we actually tried to see how bad we can mess the cars up. Because of the, you know, how the car deformed. It's kind of like, what was it, Hard Driving? I got to find Hard Driving. We have it on... I think we have it on one of the PS2 games. I will definitely check that out. I know we have been in a driving game kind of mood. I don't even know why. It just kind of started, and we're just still going with it. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. See, this is what I remember with the arcade. This is as bad as it is. is it only in 22nd place. My car is a wreck. And, you know, I'm just, it is what it is. Oh, God. Oh, God. I'm not going to make it. I'm not going to make it. Ooh. All right, come on, let's go. Come on, we got to do it. We got to do this. Come on. Oh. Oh, shoot. Nope, I'm not going to make it. I'm not going to make it. Ah. It was a good try, though. Game over. Game over. The music in this is so weird. I swear. Daytona USA. There you go. I may or may not have already done this for an Arcade Saturday. I don't even know. I don't think I have. That's why I did it. Because I don't think I have. Play other modes and clean. Let's just check this other stuff. There's karaoke. Oh, karaoke mode. I don't even know what that is. I don't even want to know what it is. Survival mode was another one I did. It was actually pretty cool. Yeah, there's nothing else in here. Oh, you can actually use a racing wheel, too. That's nice. Oh, well, anyways, there you guys go. Daytona, USA. Holy smokes. Talk about one of those classics. Was this the one? No, that was Hard Driving. Hard Driving was the big red one, looked like a Corvette. Daytona USA was the one that had the big Daytona USA. And you could hear this thing from the other side of the arcade. Because like I said, the headphones or the speakers were in the headstock. And it was right behind your head. And they were so goddamn loud. Damn, I have the top five times. I need to invite some friends over to play just so I can get my times out of there. Holy shit. Yes, I remember the buttons. They had the buttons on the console. You could do that. I don't remember if you could change the music on this one. I'm thinking Cruisin' USA was the one that you used to be able to change almost like everything in it. Daytona USA, since it was like the first, you couldn't change too much. There, you know, you could change the view and everything else, but I don't know. Definitely one of those classic games. Since I've been doing these Arcade Saturdays, it has slowly moved out of my top 10 video games of all, or arcade games of all time, only because, you know, you start playing these games, you start living, you know, you start remembering different things and start doing different things. So it's kind of moved out. I still love it. If I ever find one, I'm definitely going to stop and play it. But, I don't know, you know, it was just one that it will always have a place in my heart, definitely. And I know there's some of my friends that definitely remember it too. Love the hell out of this game. Anyways, though, that's enough spouting and nostalgia and all the crap. I thank you guys very much for coming around and checking this out. Like I said, Daytona USA from Sega. One of those really great early 90s racing games. Anyone that's ever played it will remember this bad boy. I have never raced this track. That is so ridiculous. This track right here, I've never raced it. Well, maybe I have raced. No, I've never raced this track. God, look at the... I was going to say, look how far the racing line is. Holy shit. Wow. But yeah, again, I've been nicodemoscain. This has been Arcade Saturdays. Every Saturday, we take a dollar down to the classic arcade. We find some good stuff that we can play. Unfortunately, if you play a game that costs a buck, you only get one playthrough. But we got, what, three of them through? That was all right. That wasn't so bad. We can cheat a little bit. It's my show. Damn it. We can do whatever we want. Like, comment, and subscribe if you got any enjoyment out of it at all. Let me know if you know any video games, any arcade games that you would want me to live some nostalgia through. I don't know what we're doing next week. We might keep on this racing kick. I've been threatening to do these racing games for a long time now, and I just haven't done it. So I figure let's do them. Let's go through them. Let's see what we got, and... yeah, let's have some fun. Other than that, thank you guys again for coming around. Definitely come back next week, and we shall see what's up. Until then, I wish you all well in all your future endeavors. I hope that the world lasts for you. Save your quarters and break in those turns.